My name is Kibonte Corley, and today I'm going to inform y'all about the importance of Safe Sex. Safe sex is about taking precautions. Having sex with someone of the opposite sex can lead to unintended pregnancies. And sexual contact of any kind can spread sexually transmitted diseases, or STDs. It is essential to know about safe sex before you participate in sexual activities to avoid these unwanted outcomes. One reason to have safe sex is to prevent the natural outcome of it. Sex for dummies state, knowing about condoms and birth control pills won't help you if you're in the heat and passion with someone, especially if you're both partially or fully undressed. Using contraceptives is not hard, but it takes plenty. The most reliable way to prevent pregnancy requires a trip to the doctor or clinic. Others include at least one trip to the drugstore. Condoms, when they are used correctly, do not guarantee 100% protection from unintended pregnancies. Condoms can break. If the condom is not stored correctly, or if you're not using the right lubricant, then it can break easily. You should always use water-based lubricant instead of oil-based. Do not expose condoms to prolonged heat. Don't use condoms if it is past its expiration date. And don't try to reduce the condom. Preventing disease is a very important reason to have safe sex. Even though you guard against pregnancy, you can still catch an STD. Some contraceptives don't protect against STDs. The condom is the best way to prevent STDs, but it's not the most effective against preventing pregnancies. If you are going to participate in sexual activities, make sure you take the steps to prevent STDs. With HIV spreading and other STDs already widespread, you can increase the risk if you have sex with multiple people. You may not catch an STD the first time you have a one-night stand, but every time you have one, you increase the chances of catching the STD. Even with using a condom, you can still spread STDs. According to the Department of Health and Human Services, some infections such as pubic lice, scabies, the genital wart virus, and the herpes virus are spread by close skin-to-skin contact. Condoms provide some protection against the sexually transmitted infections, but not full protection. Here are some tips on how to have safe sex. Elizabeth Boski, PhD, said that the first tip to safe sex is putting the condom on as soon as the penis gets erect. Putting on a condom on early can reduce the risk of passing STDs or STIs from skin-to-skin contact. Always leave room at the tip of the condom so there's room for ejaculation. Having sex with one partner when neither of you have STDs or STIs is the safest way to have sex. Use other types of contraceptives in addition to condoms to avoid unplanned pregnancies. Be aware that having sex while being drunk or using drugs can cause unplanned pregnancies and STDs or STIs. Always plan ahead for sex. Be prepared. Learn how to use condoms correctly. Involve condoms in foreplay, for example. Apply a condom using your hand or mouth. Educate yourself on STDs or STIs. If you want to have sex without a condom, have you and your partner get tested for STDs. If you do not have safe sex, see your doctor promptly after. Make sure you are not at risk of pregnancy or consider taking a Plan B. Consider taking a test to see if you caught an STD. Avoid vaginal or rectal dosing because it can increase the risk of infection. Having safe sex is very important. When people are having sex for recreational fun, they should really think about having sex to prevent unplanned pregnancies and STDs. No one wants to get pregnant when they are having sex for fun. And no one wants to get an STD, period. Using some of these tips I gave you today, it can help you prevent unplanned pregnancies and STDs. I encourage all of you to take action and have safe sex. Y'all have any questions?
Do you participate in same sex?
Of course. That's why I'm talking this speech.
Wanted to ask a question.
Same sex is the best sex. Any more questions?
Does it matter which condom you use?
I think that you should, you and your mate should discuss that. Like, if you want to use oil-based condoms, use them. Or if not, Trojan, Magnums, whatever. It's up to your mate.
But you would say water-based is the best to use?
Yeah, the water-based is the best. Any more questions? Thank you.